An update on the weather now. State Weather Bureau Pagasa warns of a rainy weekend in parts of the country. Pagasa says a low-pressure area inside the Philippine Area of Responsibility may intensify into a tropical depression within 24 to 48 hours. It will then be called Rosal. It will bring heavy rains over Cagayan, Isabela, Aurora, and Davao region. The LPA was last seen 415 kilometers east-northeast of Hinatuan, Surigao del Sur. But it's not seen to be as strong as Typhoon Odette, which hit the country late last year and left hundreds dead.
Nung last year po, naging bagyo na po siya sa labas. At bago siya nung tumama sa kalupaan, nag-ipon siya ng energy sa dagat. Kung para sa low pressure area, nandito na lang po siya, hindi pa siya bagyo. So, pinapakitin doon, hindi siya maging kasi lakas ni Odette po. Papayo ko, inakahanda po tayo sa worst case scenario. Na kung hindi naman dumaan, ang setto na bagyo, makakaranas po rin tayo ng malakas na pag-ulan.
The Philippine Social Welfare Department gearing up for the brewing storm. The SWD Secretary Erwin Tulfo has met with the agency's regional directors to ensure there will be enough relief supplies in areas that may be affected by the bad weather. Tulfo also instructs DSWD personnel to ramp up preparedness in case of severe flooding or landslides.
Kung hindi man po ito mag-develop into typhoon, sana hindi po, para hindi po tayo matulad dun sa Odette. Pero bantayan ho natin yung mga rainfall. Alam naman ho natin na konting ulan lang, binabaha ho kaagad na ang Mindanao. Konting ulan lang, binabaha ang Visayas and then Bicol region. So we have to be prepared. We must be prepared. Ayoko ho may marinig na may mga tao dyan sa inyong mga regions na palakad-lakad dyan at sinasabi wala pa silang nakakain. Because the instruction is clear and I'm giving you the instruction today. Ayoko pong may mabalitaan ako sa media na merong tao dyan sa inyong region na in 24 hours patapos ulanin ay hindi pa po nakakakain. Because pag yan ho ay nabasa ng Pangulo, he is not going to be very, very happy. Dahil ang instruction po ng Pangulo sa atin, gusto niya yung mga biktima ng mga kalamidad, ng mga bagyo, baha, nakakakain in less than 24 hours.
In other news, Philippine authorities say numerous Chinese vessels have been seen inching closer to the province of Palawan. According to the Western Command, in the past couple of months, the Chinese ships, mostly fishing vessels, have been monitored in several areas well within the Philippines' economic zone. The armed forces says it is taking action against the supposed swarming. The WESCOM also gathering information and documentary requirements to file diplomatic protests. Just last month, Manila sent a note verbal to Beijing after its Coast Guard allegedly seized Chinese rocket debris that the Philippine Navy had recovered in Philippine waters. A maritime law expert believes the growing presence of Chinese militia vessels near Palawan is meant to discourage Filipino fishermen from fishing in the area. Professor J. Batombacal says it may even hinder the Philippines' oil exploration plans.
The fact that they're always present means that if, for example, we were to do anything else like explore for petroleum on Reed Bank, no? Those vessels can move easily to also interfere with petroleum exploration operations. That will be just another one on the list of many contentious issues in the code of conduct discussions.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. earlier said government will try to find a way to explore for oil and gas in the West Philippine Sea, even without a deal with China.